Hello and welcome to the news from Bahrain International. I'm Sarah Lebrek. His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa received at Sakhir Palace in the presence of the personal representative of His Majesty the King, His Highness Sheikh Abdullah bin Hamad Al Khalifa, a number of citizens from the Northern Governorate to congratulate His Majesty on the occasion of the holy month of Ramadan.
وصول سيدي حضرة صاحب الجلالة ملك البلاد المعظم.
The citizens greeted His Majesty the King, wishing him many happy returns on the occasion and the kingdom progress and prosperity under His Majesty's wise leadership. They expressed thanks and appreciation to His Majesty for the royal support to the Northern Governorate reflected in His Majesty the King's directives to implement developmental projects in the Governorate. His Majesty the King welcomed the guests and exchanged good wishes on the occasion of the Holy Month, expressing appreciation for the relentless efforts exerted by the citizens of the Northern Governorate in the service of the national action, as well as their vital contributions in the development of the kingdom. His Majesty noted that the people of Bahrain have throughout history adhered to human values based on respect for all people and religions, stemming from the essence of the principles of Islam. His Majesty stressed that Bahrain will remain the one family nation of all its citizens. His Majesty also affirmed the concrete progress and development in the kingdom, which are based on solid foundations laid by the efforts of the ancestors. His Majesty the King lauded the people of Bahrain for their active contribution to building the nation's development, in addition to their efficiency and sincerity in carrying out their responsibilities in various production and work fields, which qualified them to assume leadership positions, whether locally or on the Arab and international levels. His Majesty wished that the holy month of Ramadan be a month of goodness and blessings for everyone, and to perpetuate the blessings of security, safety, prosperity, and stability for the kingdom and its people.
سيدي حضرة صاحب الجلالة الملك حمد بن عيسى الخليفة ملك البلاد المعظم حفظه الله ورعاه، أصحاب السمو، أصحاب المعالي والسعادة، أيها الحضور الكريم، السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته، ونرحب بكم في هذا اللقاء الذي يعكس طبيعة شعب البحرين بتكاتف أهله وتواصلهم والتفافهم حولكم يا صاحب الجلالة قائداً لمسيرة التنمية والسلام والتعايش والازدهار. خير ما نبدأ به تلاوة عطرة من القرآن الكريم.
After that, verses from the Holy Quran were recited.
علي صلاح عمر.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما إنا عرضنا الأمانة على السماوات والأرض والجبال فأبين أن يحملنها وأشفقن منها وحملها الإنسان إنه كان ظلوما جهولا ليعذب الله المنافقين والمنافقات والمشركين والمشركات ويتوب الله على المؤمنين والمؤمنات وكان الله غفورا رحيما صدق الله العظيم.
كلمة أهالي المحافظة الشمالية
Dr. Mahmoud Ibrahim Rashid Trada has delivered a speech on this occasion on behalf of citizens of the Northern Governorate, wishing His Majesty the King, the government, the people of Bahrain, the Arab and Islamic nations many happy returns. He hailed His Majesty's reform approach of religious pluralism, which reflects His Majesty's vision of peaceful and humanitarian coexistence, which strengthens the principles of tolerance and dialogue among all people, as affirmed by His Holiness the Pope of the Vatican during his historic visit to the kingdom in the presence of the Grand Imam of Al-Azhar, Dr. Ahmed Al-Tayyib. He commended the government's action plan spearheaded by His Royal Highness, the Crown Prince, Deputy Supreme Commander of the Armed Forces, and Prime Minister and Deputy Bahrain leader, Prince Salman bin Hamad Al-Khalifa. He congratulated His Majesty the King on the positive growth indicators revealed in the 2022 Bahrain Economic Reports, hailing development projects and Bahrain's ranking in the international competitiveness reviews. He highlighted key projects implemented by the Northern Governorate to enhance low-income citizens' standards of living and address humanitarian cases, citing in particular the charity program Buyut Homes. Dr. Thada has praised His Majesty the King's vision and approach aimed to consolidate social cohesion, cement national unity, and further root the values of national belonging and citizenship upon the directives of the Minister of Interior, General Sheikh Rashid bin Abdullah Al-Khalifa. He noted the Northern Governorate's support to the mass wedding, which was organized by Al-Hamala Cultural Charity and social society embodying national unity, belonging to the national nation, and the firm spirit of citizenship. Rada asserted that His Majesty's support resulted in the successes achieved by the governorate, citing the listing of Ali as a healthy city by the World Health Organization. He reiterated allegiance to His Majesty the King, wishing him abundant health and happiness to continue the march of progress in the kingdom.
إن النهج الحضاري والإصلاحي لجلالتكم الساعي نحو التقارب بين الأديان قد أرسل رسائل السلام والوئام في العالم أجمع وهو بالتأكيد انعكاس للسيرة الحضارية والرؤية الملكية السامية والحكيمة للتعايش السلمي والإنساني التي تعزز قيم ومبادئ السلام والتسامح والحوار بين كل الشعوب بثقافاتها وحضاراتها المختلفة باعتبارها من الركائز الأصيلة والثوابت الراسخة للمجتمع البحريني المتسامح والمتآخي والحضاري منذ قديم الزمن. وهو ما أكده قداسة باب الفاتيكان خلال تلبيته لدعوتكم الكريمة بحضور شيخ الأزهر الشريف خلال الزيارة التاريخية في شهر نوفمبر الماضي، لترتقي بجلالتكم البحرين على خارطة العالم للتسامح الديني من خلال العديد من المبادرات، ومنها تدشين وثيقة إعلان مملكة البحرين وجائزة عيسى لخدمة الإنسانية وإنشاء مركز الملك حمد العالمي للتعايش السلمي وبرنامج الملك حمد للحوار بين الأديان والتعايش السلمي في جامعة سابيانزا بجمهورية إيطاليا، والنجاح الباهر باستضافة المملكة لأعمال الدورة 146 للجمعية العامة للاتحاد البرلماني الدولي، ودعوتكم المباركة لإقرار اتفاقية دولية لتجريم خطابات الكراهية الدينية والطائفية والعنصرية في جميع صورها. وما العمل الفني المقدم لجلالتكم باسم أهالي المحافظة الشمالية إلا تجسيد لنهج جلالتكم العالمي للتعايش السلمي؟ سيدي صاحب الجلالة، إن المحافظة الشمالية تستلهم تنفيذ سياساتها من برنامج العمل الحكومي برئاسة صاحب السمو الملكي الأمير سلمان بن حمد آل خليفة ولي العهد نائب القائد الأعلى رئيس مجلس الوزراء حفظه الله ورعاه قائد فريق البحرين، مباركين لجلالتكم ما أشار إليه التقرير الاقتصادي لمملكة البحرين للعام 2022 حول تحقيق النمو الإيجابي للمؤشرات الاقتصادية إلى جانب مستجدات المشروع أو المشاريع التنموية، وأداء المملكة في التقارير والمؤشرات التنافسية الدولية بما يدفع تطبيق الأولويات التي تسعى الحكومة الموقرة لتنفيذها نحو التحول من التعافي إلى النمو إلى مزيد من الخير والنماء والازدهار للوطن والمواطن. ومن أبرز البرامج التي تقدمها المحافظة الشمالية في هذا الصدد والتي تهدف إلى الارتقاء بالمستوى المعيشي لذوي الدخل المحدود البرنامج الخيري بيوت، بالإضافة إلى بحث الحالات الإنسانية في المجتمع والتعاون في مختلف القطاعات الحكومية والخاصة والأهلية بهدف متابعة تنفيذ الحلول الطارئة. سيدي صاحب الجلالة، لقد انتهجت المحافظة الشمالية نهجكم السامي في لم الشمل وتعزيز النسيج الاجتماعي الواحد وتجذير الوحدة الوطنية لترسيخ الانتماء وقيم المواطنة. وما دعم المحافظة الشمالية لحفل الزواج الجماعي الوطني لأبناء الطائفتين الكريمتين الذي أقيم في شهر مارس الماضي بتنظيم من جمعية الهملة الثقافية الخيرية الاجتماعية إلا أحد البرامج التوعوية لتجسيد روح الأسرة الواحدة بما يصب في تعزيز الوحدة الوطنية بين أبناء الوطن الواحد ويدعم الخطة الوطنية لتعزيز الانتماء الوطني وترسيخ قيم المواطنة في لوحة فنية بديعة التقى فيها أبناء البحرين ليعبروا عن رغبتهم الصادقة في لم الشمل وإيمانهم بوحدة المصير المشترك الذي يجمعهم الإرث الحضاري والتاريخ الواحد. سيدي صاحب الجلالة، إن المحافظة الشمالية وبفضل قيادتكم الحكيمة للمشروع الإصلاحي قد كتبت قصة نجاح جديد عبر اعتماد عالي مدينة صحية ضمن برنامج المدن الصحية من خلال تطبيق أعلى معايير الاعتماد العالمي في تحسين نوعية الحياة وتحقيق متطلبات التنمية الأساسية وإيجاد بيئة داعمة للصحة وتشجيع المجتمع على المشاركة الإيجابية وصولاً إلى التنمية المستدامة الشاملة وبالتنسيق مع مختلف الجهات المحلية والعالمية وصولاً لتحقيق رؤية المحافظة عالي نحو اعتماد الشمالية محافظة صحية. وفي الختام، إن أبناء المحافظة الشمالية الذين يكنون لجلالتكم كل الحب والولاء للذود عن هذا الوطن بكل غال ونفيس قد آلوا على أنفسهم تجديد البيعة والولاء لجلالتكم داعين الله عز وجل أن يحفظكم ويرعاكم ويسدد على طريق الخير خطاكم إنه سميع مجيب. والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
At the end of the reception, the Northern Governor, Ali Al-Usfour, presented His Majesty the King with a commemorative gift, and His Majesty exchanged friendly conversations with the citizens of the governorate.
دكتور علي ما يحتاج أعرفكم، بس بالنسبة لي هذا أستاذي، تعلمت منه الكثير والحقيقة كان صبور. بدينا بدايات متواضعة في الدولة من أيام مجلس الدولة، وكان دائما متفائل، والحقيقة المؤمن لازم يكون متفائل، وإحنا من مدرسة التفاؤل، والحقيقة السبب هو أنتم. أخلاق البحرين وأهل البحرين هي اللي تدفع الإنسان إلى التفاؤل وإلى الإنجاز العظيم. مشكورين على الزيارة وكل عام وأنتم بخير.
His Majesty hailed the efforts of Dr. Ali Fakhru since the beginning of the State's Council, affirming that he was dedicated to the country and was His Majesty's mentor. His Majesty added that the honorable people of Bahrain inspire optimism about the future of the country. Then the Northern Governor expressed his gratitude to His Majesty the King for receiving the citizens of the Northern Governorate and extended his best wishes of the holy month of Ramadan, wishing His Majesty many happy returns. His Majesty commended the approach. He recommended the approach of His Majesty the King's towards consolidating the values of peace and tolerance and the global initiatives led by His Majesty in this area. He wished His Majesty abundant health and happiness to continue the march of reform with the support of His Royal Highness the Crown Prince and Prime Minister. He said those efforts have taken Bahrain from a phase of recovery to a phase of unprecedented growth in light of the economic indicators announced lately. He also pledged loyalty to His Majesty the King. His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa ratified and issued Law 1 of the year 2023, ratifying an agreement between the government of Bahrain and the Council of Ministers of Bosnia and Herzegovina and on air services following its approval by the Shura Council signed in Manama on November 9, 2022, and attached to this law. His Royal Highness the Crown Prince and Prime Minister Prince Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa yesterday visited the majlises of the Al Khawaji family, the Kazaruni family, and the majlis of Yusuf Abdul Wahab Al Hawaj and Sons. His Royal Highness highlighted Team Bahrain's efforts towards furthering the kingdom's comprehensive development led by His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa. His Royal Highness noted that Bahraini citizens remain at the heart of all development initiatives, emphasizing the government's commitment to introducing innovative projects that deliver for all Bahrainis. His Royal Highness highlighted the newly introduced golden license to advance the kingdom's competitiveness, provide quality job opportunities for Bahrainis, and attract large-scale investments in the national economy. His Royal Highness exchanged Ramadan blessings with the hosts and guests of the majlises and commended Bahrain's dedication to preserving the customs, values, and traditions that connect the past, present, and future. For their part, the majlis hosts and guests expressed their gratitude to His Royal Highness for his visit and commended his efforts to further the kingdom's economic and social development. His Royal Highness was accompanied by the chairman of the Board of Trustees of the Isa bin Salman Educational Charitable Trust, His Highness Sheikh Isa bin Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa, and His Highness Sheikh Mohammed bin Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa. We'll be right back. The first deputy chairman of the Supreme Council for Youth and Sports, chairman of the General Sports Authority, the GSA, and president of Bahrain Olympic Committee, the BOC, His Highness Sheikh Khalid bin Hamad Al Khalifa, yesterday attended the second edition of the Ramadan Sports Games 2023 in the presence of the GSA vice chairman, His Highness Sheikh Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa. The Minister of Cabinet Affairs, Undersecretary, and BOC Vice President His Highness Sheikh Isa bin Ali bin Khalifa Al Khalifa, and Presidents of Sports Clubs and Federations, His Highness affirmed that the sports games organized by GSA represents an opportunity for harmony between the Presidents of Sports Clubs and Federations. His Highness also affirmed that the sports games are in line with the noble religious anti-humanitarian values of the blessed month of Ramadan. His Highness Sheikh Khalid noted the keenness to organize various forums and gatherings that contribute to strengthening ties and social relations between sports leaders, which will have a positive impact on cooperation and joint work to develop the sports work system. He expressed pleasure in the success achieved by the event through its wide participation, expressing hope that this annual meeting will continue to enhance cohesion among all participants. The Al Jarm team won first place, the Tidus team came in second, and the Awal team came in third. The participants expressed thanks to His Highness Sheikh Khalid for his pioneering initiative. The Council of Representatives held its weekly session presided over by its Speaker Ahmed Al-Musallam. The session began with presenting the response to the questions submitted by the members of the Minister of Housing and Urban Planning and the Minister of Municipalities Affairs and Agriculture. The Council then discussed a request for clarification of the government's policy in reviewing salary scales in the public sector and the levels of wages of workers in the private sector and the proportionality of those salaries and wages with the rates of high prices and inflation, and for clarification of the government's policy on hiring the unemployed in various specializations.